In the event of evolution of the civilized mankind, different sectorial fragmentations concerned with various values of the society emerge, like the social responsibilities and development, culture, spiritualism and religion, economic factors, political dimensions, and innumerable interrelated and consequential binding issues. Coming to economy, economy is the visible destiny. We are talking about some other destiny, some other scribbling which is ineffable, unintelligible, indescribable. The visible destiny of the world is its economy. And economy is never to be read, or designed, or concluded, or considered as a separate entity. It is a reflection of the various social considerations that exist, political factors, cultural factors, various other factors of ethical, moral, as well as the rest and unrest that works in the society. Everything describes the economic fate of the society. And considering recession, recession is not yet new bride. We have seen innumerable recessions, but due to the advent of communication era, and moreover, as we are facing something in this global village, where we have dependence, more dependence with various other foreign countries, and more transactions are taking place with more intimacy and proximity inside, within, across and beyond borders of various nations. We are seeing it very conspicuously, but recession is very common. Since 1854, we have seen at least 32 expansions and contractions in the US economy. So it is something very new, it is casual, it is unavoidable. Whenever there is a symptom, just as we have our pathology and anatomy for our physical organism, there is a social anatomy or socio-economical anatomy in which some sort of mistakes, intentionally or unintentionally, something which we have been negligent of or ignorant of, subservient of, that we will fostering and nourishing due to some various other reasons. It naturally occurs in a period of time and starting in 6 months to 2 years. It is essentially, it should take root in the society. So it is a casual symptom of the society to get into recession. But it is also our wanted duty that we see that our controlling ability and ability of revival should be grown. Total prevention of recession is unimaginable and fictional. And that is where recession is very common, but the vulnerability of the recession that differs between various countries. Some countries may face limited growth, in some areas it may be stagnation, some area retrogression, some area it may be total exhaustion, some area due to economic collapse it may result in various aggressions spoiling the tranquility of the society even. There are innumerable societies in the economy which we call as sitting economy, sleeping economy, senseless economy, crawling economy, moving economy, running economy, and riding economy. Innumerable economical status are there. So vulnerability and influence rates, they differ between various nations. There is also a fundamental study, common study, and also the exclusive study for India and its grounds. I wish that this seminar has been arranged for the concluding remarks of the exclusive steps that are to be taken and that have been taken for the economic appraisal of the country. And you know that recession, it is a transactive cyclic contraction, which in economic terms they say that it is two down quarters of the GDP, which naturally occurs reflecting in distribution, also in production, in employment, in real personal income, and also the real value of the GDP growth. It is what it occurs. And the economists here, they are going to discuss about various things, where it is a retrievable, irretrievable, obvious and double dip, which are there, explained in P model, U model, W model, and L models of economy, which is going to the economists now. And coming to the real impact of economy that is to be studied and pondered upon at this stage is, number one, we all very much know that India has all these things. I just think we are having that limited vulnerability. No doubt we are dependent on US economy and we are affected. But our distantiveness and revival is also very much well seen. As per the expectation, we are not so much affected by this thing which I just seen that. And considering the agenda, because I have been given only 10 minutes of time, generally I used to deliver the lecture for 1 hour or like that, it should be focusing on how we can. But still, so considering the limited time, and also I should present some sort of justice to the topic. So I want to say here clearly about some major things which we are going to be exclusive from what you are going to be. Number one, There are having three major things to understand here. One is trans-economic zone, second is meta-economic zone, and third thing is para-economic zone. Apart from economy, I already told that everything is influencing economy. And more than somebody told about God factor in economy. Then somebody explained God is G for gold reserve and O for oil reserve of the fossil fuel economy and D for the dollar currency. That is the third of modern economy. Apart from this conventional study, we have some other rulings also inside. For example, diversions, dilutions and dilapidations of economy should be studied. The first diversion is total unrest, calamity in the society due to disruptivism and various other troublesome factors, which has induced military mechanisms, military methodologies, and enrichment of military scientific status, etc. So that there is a diversion. Second thing is science and technology. Science and technology, innumerable things for investment, infrastructure, research, failure investigations. Then compensation of failures, new methodologies, expansions in space research. Chandrayaan, you know about various stories that we have to discuss. So science and technology, that is also a major diversion. The third diversion that deals with the health hazards of the society, in which most of the diversion occurs. Fourth factor is about the environmental hazards that we are facing now. And the fifth thing is about the corruption. It's a major factor of direction in society. And this type of corruption, that is a very, very great socio-political thing, whereby corruption is encouraged by somebody and corruption embellishes somebody, so it is a very big socio-political factor. And it has a vicious circles of effect in the society which cannot be dealt with mere economical view. And apart from that, clandestine enrichment. Swiss banks, you know that there are 70 lakhs of crores of our unclaimed deposit that is there, sleeping with a relative in other foreign banks. Lot of these various factors are that they come under trans-economic ethical zone. And second thing is that comes under meta-economics. Apart from our near economical study, how to make people to live simply, the simplicity of life, what is luxury? Luxury has become now necessity. And in future, luxury will become the total instinctive way of human life itself. So luxury and simplicity, hope and courage to live. People, they have grown rich, but their hope of survival and their courage to lead a life at the time of distress and crisis has totally been vanished. So that hope and courage, that is a psychological factor, that is also there. And substitution and alternative ways of survival. That's why somebody asked, which is the best technology and suitable technology for the world? That is survival technology. How to survive at the time of distress, despair, isolation, loss, crisis? This is the real technology. These come under meta-economics. And para-economics is extra contextual because that deals with the intuitive guidance for us to understand, appreciate and develop the models of economy, as well as it deals with some other moral fabric of the society, which maybe I have already told, over contextual. So considering these three various regions, we have to distinguish how for Indian context it can be developed. Coming to the concluding session, I want to say, number one, each and every country has it is known as R, it is known as R phenomenon. Each and every country has innumerable R's in economic progress or economic stability. It starts with number one, rudimentary factors of the socio-political mind setup and the general public consensus. That means there is a rudimentary value. Apart from that, there are resources, then there are reserves, and whenever there is a problem, there is a review, react, the response, then the reforms and reflection and needs of the society. The major part of the society is not the reforms. Reflection of the knowledge about the reforms in the society and reach of the benefit to the last member of the last citizen of the country, that is a bigger problem rather than this type of reforms which are committed within closed audience and elite circle. The reflection and reach problem.